Hey there, friend. Today, we're unboxing and reviewing the Yinker 15.6-inch dual-screen laptop extender, a lightweight add-on that's like two extra screens bolted onto your laptop. We'll test its portability, display quality, and rotation modes, so stay tuned until the end of the video.
Well, we got a real special one to open up today from Yinker, the 15.6-inch dual screen extender for laptop. As you can see, we're going to extend the screen real estate on your laptop. I am so excited to get into the box. A lot of information on the back here. We're going to talk about that as we go through the video. Oh, that's satisfying. Just slide right up like that. Nice to see. We got the user guide. Speaking of setup, we got a nice quick setup guide here, which I think is very, very nice. I, of course, will follow this exactly as instructed. Connection method here, just to give you a little idea of how it's supposed to work. Now, a little disclaimer, I don't own a laptop, but my son does. So we're going to be using his. Obviously, we got a nice little carrying case, not that big. So that's nice to see. This probably doesn't take up that much space, which is going to be very, very nice. So, okay, a little bit of protective cardboard inside the box here. Now, this looks like, yep, this is very, very nice. Very, very nice. Oh, and I just want to see what else we have included in the box. Okay, all right, no big deal. We'll check that out. What else is in here? This looks like a power brick. Power here. Ooh, I like the orange. 15-watt charger there. Okay, that does open up just like that. Okay, what do we got here? USB-A to USB-C, and I like that it's got that little angled connector, probably for compatibility when you're connecting it. And then inside this bag, what is this? More cables, perhaps? Yeah, that's a different... Okay. What does it say? If the screen flickers, please connect a power adapter. Okay, so obviously you have to give this device enough power. And, you know, our laptop in the house isn't the most modern. It's not the very newest model. So we're probably going to have to use whatever accessories required. This feels good. We're going to take this out of the package. I'm going to be very careful. I will be following the instructions of how to unfold it. I don't want to mess around with anything. I don't want to break it. I'm trying to be very, very gentle here. Oh, yeah. Okay, so not a touchscreen, no built-in battery. Remove the protective film and choose the sequence angle. This feels like lovely. It's got a beautiful feel, but let's check it out. That's what's in the box. Lovely. Feels really high-end. Like, it just feels really, really nice. So we're going to check it out. We're going to set it up, and we're going to see how it works. All right, so I want to unfold this correctly. And as you can see by the picture, it's sort of like a ZZ Fold device here. We're going to open up the right display screen first and then open the left display here. So just like that to open it and again to close it. So I just want to see the design, the build quality of the monitor. This is a little, you know, like a screen protector type of thing. So I don't want to mess with it here, especially before I get to know it very well. And let's just clarify on the picture here. Okay, so I think I'm doing it correctly. No, I'm not. That is actually backwards. I think that's the right one. Yeah. Yeah, that's the right one. And obviously, I think if you're really careful here, you could probably do it either way. It feels nice. It feels snug. You know, it feels really substantial. We're going to have to give a little wider shot here to get a full effect of how big this is and how much additional real estate this is actually going to give you with a regular laptop, which is exciting. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Look at that. It's kind of obvious now that I get a feel for it, how it goes together. Yep. There we go. There we go. Oh, my gosh. This is amazing. It feels awesome. Like, the build quality of it feels really, really good. I will take off those protective screen covers when we're ready to use it. But of course, I want to follow the instructions. I want to set it up properly. This feels amazing. And just folding this device back up just to kind of confirm its design. It says to fold the left side first. Okay, stand by. Just trying to... Oh, there we go. There we go. Yeah, the hinges are nice. Like they're tight. They feel really secure, you know. And I, of course, I'm just a little bit afraid to break it. This is not a, you know, it's not a toy. It's not a cheap device. This is a productivity tool. And if you look at that, it seems really, really nice. Let's just check out the carrying case and how well it all fits inside. See how, you know, how snug it is, how it's designed to fit inside. Ooh, it's got a nice little like velvety feeling on the inside. I wasn't expecting that. That's nice. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Fits in there. Lovely little carrying case. And of course, there's little side pockets here. So you should, I'm hoping, be able to bring all your accessories. Oh yeah, this is designed in a very thoughtful way. You got your supplemental power. You can bring your drivers with you. Might like to see like a little Velcro piece or something just to hold that together. But overall, this isn't the kind of thing you're going to be flinging around anyway. I think this is awesome. This is designed to be portable and productive. And I'm excited to see how it looks, how it feels. Let's check it out. Okay, so just going to connect this USB to drive. The USB-C port is in the back of the laptop. So nicely. Okay, so we've got the auto run here. So they've got this folder broken down. It's got Android, Linux, Mac OS, and Windows, which is really, really nice to see. It's got Windows 7 to 8.1 folder, and then Windows 10 to Windows 11. This laptop has Windows 11. Then it's just got the regular executable here. Can't see that super duper well, but this is working just fine so far. Get those drivers installed. Okay, this installer will install Silicone Motion display driver to your computer. So let's go ahead and install that. Big deal, just a couple of moments. That's it. Boom. That's all. Just takes a couple of seconds. Quite literally, that's a very nice, easy way to get that set up. Now let's work on setting up the hardware. Okay, so I definitely love everything I see so far, except there's one little problem just with this particular laptop because the battery isn't charged right now. And let's be honest, batteries don't stay charged all the time. And it sort of has this like barrel plug that comes out of the back of the laptop. And because it's not USB-C charged, it's really only able to plug in there to charge it. However, the back frame here doesn't have a cutout, like it's exactly the right size as far as the width. And once the battery is charged, I'll be able to have this snug up against it to give you that traditional look. Now it has a little kickstand in the back, which, you know, from this angle, it looks perfect, but it's just not as close to the other monitors as I would like them just because of the way this laptop is designed. So, you know, depending on your laptop, obviously if it charges from the side or something like that, it wouldn't be a problem because then you could just route it through these cutouts. So I would like to see like an additional cutout along the bottom of this back stand. I don't know if that would affect the structural integrity, but just so that it kind of matched up with the back of this laptop. But there's so many different laptop designs that obviously they can't plan for every single one, but I do have to point out my findings with the hardware that I have to work with. So we got the USB-C cable that's installed with it. Well, this laptop is plugged in. I'm still going to go ahead and connect the Yinker displays here. Obviously, I've installed the drivers. So let's go ahead and plug this into... So this little... hang on. Angled bit connects in here. And then this cord... Again, it would be nice if there was a cutout on the bottom of this here. So everything could come. Oh, look at that. Everything comes on instantly already without touching anything. Looking very, very nice. The laptop is, I'm gonna go into Windows here. There we go. Let's get into Windows. Now, I do have the instructions here and I'm having a little peek. Oh, here we go. Here we go. Oh yeah. Let's go in here. Something
Oh yeah, I got my mouse over here. It's not bringing the background with me, but if I was to open a window already, oh my gosh, I'm already starting to really love this thing. Can I bring this window over? Let's see. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. We're cooking. We're cooking. We've got productivity here. Now, so this is mirroring the main display and then the second on the right. So I'm pretty sure that if I right click on the desktop and I go to display settings, let's identify. Okay, so this is a Windows setting. We want to extend desktop on 1 and 2. Let's try to, I think, keep changes. Yeah, there we go. There we go. And actually, I want to switch. I like 2 on the left and 3 on the right, I think. But again, your mileage may vary. I'm going to apply these settings. Now, yep, that left is on the left, right is on the right. I can tell you right away that the color of the Yinker monitor is much, much better, as you can see, than this kind of yellowed out, washed out color on the main display. Like, right away, this looks absolutely incredible. And when I sit down at a chair, even though the laptop is literally a few inches, well, not like a few inches, it's about, I don't know, 4 centimeters away, 3 centimeters away from the back of the laptop. Even with this G15 that does not have a ton of power, I can already see that this is looking incredible. That was so easy to set up. It doesn't require anything other than a 30-second driver installation. You plug it in with USB-C, bada bing, you're good to go. I mean, you're going to look a little crazy in the coffee shop, but you know people are going to be stopping you and asking, like, what the heck is that? How can I get one? I can tell you, this is absolutely amazing. So we'll do a few tests. We'll check it out. We'll try to run a couple of programs on it, see how it works with the laptop. But honestly, the initial setup, everything was simple, easy. It's working perfectly, you know, and even if you don't need it immediately, you got a cool little extra power adapter in case you do. But wow, Mike, my first impression here, this is incredible. And depending on the setup of the ports on your laptop, it may or may not work even better. I just wish this wasn't a barrel plug on this laptop and it would charge through the USB-C port. But again, it's a lower level laptop, not exactly designed maybe for professionals, but it's, yeah, this is pretty darn cool. So I'm just going to click on one. Yeah, this is good. So let's get out of the settings here and I'm going to give it a test. I'm going to play around with it. But as you can see, I think this is already really, really cool. And just looking through the instructions a little bit more, and there's also this on-screen display. Each one has it. This one is just hiding behind the corner. If you just click quickly on the plus button, it allows you to increase the brightness. Now, I can't believe that's not already on max brightness. I'm going to turn it all the way up. I want to see how bright it gets. And let's go, go, go. That's 70, 80, 90. There's 100% brightness. I mean, it looks beautiful. The white is so white. The black is so black. That really is a perfect example of the color that you're going to get on it. Again, I'm going to push the plus button here. Yep, simple. That's only on 30% default here. Because obviously, you know, with laptops, you're trying to conserve power. But with this kind of setup, I can see this being sort of like a permanent home setup. Pair it with like a nice docking station. Oh, yeah. Turn that brightness up. I'm going to open up a few different display, you know, different programs and such to see how smoothly everything keeps working while it's connected. But honestly, this is awesome. Like, it's really, really cool. And okay, so I've got 3 YouTube videos all running in full screen mode. These monitors, the Yinker displays, look infinitely better than the standard Dell G15 monitor. Now, of course, it's set on, you know, laptop power conservation settings, as you might expect, but overall, these are looking so crispy, so clean. I'm absolutely in love with what I'm looking at, what I'm working with. It took absolutely nothing to set it up. Everything just seems to work just perfectly, and there's no noticeable latency or any kind of delay or lag. It's just working flawlessly, exactly what you would expect. In fact, easier and better than I would have expected. I'm pretty blown away right now, and I think that this is, from what I can see, an absolutely awesome looking product. So I do just want to quickly mention that the display here has a viewable screen size of 344 millimeters by 194. They're both running at 1080p
And the aspect ratio is 16 by 9, 16.7 million colors. And they're operating at a color temperature of 6800K. I think this is absolutely amazing. The refresh rate is 60 hertz. So I don't know that you're going to be playing like fast-paced games on them necessarily. But with a laptop, are you really usually doing that anyway? I don't know that it would work quite so well for like, you know, widescreen games. But it's not to say that you couldn't try. With some games, I think you definitely could get away with that. It would be absolutely amazing. But for this particular setup, you know, if you've got a video running, maybe you're doing your work and then you have like a conference call or something like that. This to me is an absolute game changer. You take a regular boring old laptop and you turn it into an absolute powerhouse of productivity, entertainment, and absolutely, this is something that if you got this for a student, for somebody who's, you know, working on the road, trying to get things done, you don't want to bring multiple laptops with you. You just want to get your work done. Because as you can see here at home, I got multiple displays. I think most people do these days. And this is looking, working, and feeling incredible.
All right. I just want to quickly show you how portable this thing really is. I got my backpack here. And this bag is beautiful, but it's not super huge. Now we got the full laptop here. Same one we used in the video. Which honestly, it's a bit big for this bag. It fits in there nicely. And this thing is even easier to fit inside. Just like that, no big deal. You can take this thing anywhere.
I'm absolutely loving how crisp those dual 1080p IPS displays are, as they honestly outshine my laptop screen. If you want the simplicity of single cable plug and play and three folding modes, including flat, tilted, and triangle, this could be your next big upgrade. I wish there was a power port cutout in the back where it would match up with my laptop, but that's something Yinker could probably address in future revisions, but depending on your laptop model, this might not even be a consideration. If you found this helpful, tap the like button, hit subscribe, and ring that bell so you don't miss any future reviews. Click the link to the product in the video description. Thank you so much for watching.